Ready.
So the poem I chose was Coaching Winter Track in Time of War. It's by the poet W.D. Earhart, who is an ex-Marine and Vietnam War veteran. And now he is a history teacher and he coaches track at the Haverford School in Pennsylvania, hence the name Coaching Winter Track in Time of War. So just to introduce the poem, when I read it, I split it up into two parts. In the first part, there's a more proud tone, and he parallels these young track athletes with young soldiers from his time, and even today. And you'll see that in the wording of the poem. And in the second part of the poem, it takes on a more reflective and somber tone, where he speaks from experience on war and what it's like. So without further ado, here's Coaching Winter Track in Time of War. The boys are running suicides out on a football field today. 10-yard increments, out to the 50, and back again. Push-ups in between. It's 30 degrees, but they sweat like it's summer in Baghdad. Curse like soldiers. They swear to God they'll see you burn in hell. You could fall in love with boys like these. So earnest, so eager, so ready to do whatever you ask. Sure of you, trusting, full of themselves and the world. But how do you tell them it's not that simple? How do you tell them, question it all, question everything, even a coach, even a president? How do you tell them? Ask the young dead soldiers coming home each night in aluminum boxes. None of us is allowed to see an army of shades. You tell the boys, good work, and call it a day. Stand alone in fading light while memory's phantoms circle the track like weary athletes running a race without a finish line. So, as you can see, as I mentioned before, you know, in the first part, he parallels these track athletes with young soldiers. And you can see that where in the first stanza he says these kids curse like soldiers. And, you know, he describes them as, you know, they're ready to take on the world, they're full of pride, so ready to do whatever you ask, and you should, you know, just do good and please you. And he's proud of these boys because, you know, they're putting in all this effort, and as I said, they just want to do good. But in the second part, he takes on a more somber tone. He asks himself, you know, how do I let these kids know that you need to reflect, you need to question the motives and purpose of anything you do. You don't just go in blind doing something because you want to please someone else, you know. And he takes on his experiences from having served in Vietnam, where war is ugly, you know, people die in every single war, and you know, you got to reflect on why are we there, what are we doing, what's the purpose behind this. And you know, he says, just look at all these aluminum boxes coming home, these young dead soldiers, and you know, you can't really see them because they're gone. And then in the end, you know, he's standing alone, everyone else has gone home on the football field, and you know, the light's fading, and I took that as, you know, he's there alone with these haunting memories that have no finish line. You know, they keep coming back, and you can never forget the memories of war. And while he's standing alone, the light's fading, which I took that as, you know, as the rest of the world forgets and moves on, you know, you being there and experiencing all those horrors, it sticks with you, and it'll never go away.